he repeated the rhetoric said by Kristen Wong-Tam and the fake news out there. And he labeled every biblical Christian, that's every Pentecostal, every Baptist, everyone that believes in the Bible, he labeled us all as homophobic, transphobic, and he said he's going to stand with another community, one community. Now, I don't even have to name that community, but what is a Toronto mayor doing siding with one community when Toronto is filled with many communities? They say they believe in diversity. They say they believe in inclusion. They say in equity. But equity, diversity, and inclusion is not being biased and making blanket statements as a mayor in the media. That's called discrimination. If we are so evil and we are so bad, then why in the world do you force every judge before going into office to put their hands on the Bible? Why do you force every lawyer before being accepted into the Law Society of Ontario or any law society in Canada to put their hand on the Bible? Do you think the Bible is the final authority? And if so, then why are you discriminating against us? Our God reigns! The blatant hypocrisy, the fact that there is a counter-protest shows you that that's not, they don't believe in inclusion. Inclusion and diversity means everybody is welcome on a street. If you're going to block any member of the community from a public sidewalk and a public street and say that we can't walk up Church Street, that's discrimination. Now some of you are saying, well, maybe we shouldn't walk up Church Street. Why? Nobody! Why should my children and your children's children and my community be afraid to walk on a public sidewalk that we pay our taxes for? This is not about targeting any community. We already said we love the LGBT community. We love the LGBT community. Amen? We just want to be treated with dignity and respect like anybody else. Nobody should have to walk on eggshells in any community. And if you have to fear walking on in any community, that means there's criminals there that need to be arrested. If you walk through a ghetto and you're afraid, it's because somebody's holding a gun. If I walk on the street and I'm afraid because I'm a Christian, that means somebody needs to be arrested. And it's not the preacher, it's the criminals. And I'm not saying everybody over here is a criminal. But what I'm saying is that when you obstruct justice and bar streets from a community, that's unjust. We're going to hear from Peter Ruparella, the president of Voices of the Nation. He was almost banned from Dundas Square for saying Jesus is Lord in a song at a Christian festival. We want to hear from him.
Yeah, but let me tell you something. I was there in the other side. They almost killed me there. Okay, listen, this is what I'm saying to you. I was there. They almost kicked me there. They almost killed me there. Right now, 10 minutes ago. So you are here. You're signed here. Nobody's attacking you. Okay, sure. You're safe, right? Because this is God we believe in. Because we are born again believers. Because you're not full of demons like the people there. Do you understand?
We love you. And you know, the more that everyone can get involved, whether or not you're a Christian, whether you're Buddhist, whatever, you're loved. Thank you. Thank you.
So they're going to